Hello friends, if you want to buy a new Wi-Fi router but confused which Wi-Fi router to buy because in market there are many Wi-Fi routers available at different price, but out of all these routers which will be the best one for you? So watch this video till the end. In this video I am going to discuss Wi-Fi router's technical specification in detail. Friends, before starting the video, if you have not subscribed to my channel, then please subscribe first and press the bell icon for new video notification. So first, let's talk about Wi-Fi bands. As you know, Wi-Fi routers operates on two frequency bands, 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz. All the Wi-Fi router with IEEE, B, G and standard operates on 2.4 GHz frequency band, while Wi-Fi with IEEE, A, AC AX standard operates on 5 GHz frequency band. All the Wi-Fi routers on which 802.11bgn is written uses single frequency band 2.4 GHz called as single band Wi-Fi routers, while Wi-Fi routers on which 802.11abgn ac AX is written uses two frequency band 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz is called as dual band Wi-Fi routers. Routers with 802.11n standard, also known as 4G routers, and routers with 802.11ac standard, known as 5G routers, and latest with 802.11ax standard, known as 6G Wi-Fi routers. So while buying a Wi-Fi router, check router is single band or dual band. Second is speed. On router, you may have seen written like N150, N300, AC750, AC1200, AC1600 and so on. So what are these numbers? These are Wi-Fi routers advertised speed. N150 will give maximum speed of 150 Mbps data rate and 300 will give maximum speed of 300 Mbps data rate. If router is dual band like AC750, then it is combined speed of both the bands. Many people think that AC750 will give 750 Mbps data rate speed, but it's not like that. It's a combined speed of both the bands. On 2.4 GHz, it will give 300 Mbps data rate speed, and on 5 GHz, it will give 433 Mbps data rate speed. So total is 733 Mbps, but for advertised purpose, 750 Mbps is written. So all those numbers are advertised speed. Before buying a new router, check what speed it will give on 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz frequency band. All these speeds are Wi-Fi router's internal speed. Means if you transfer files from one computer to another computer or a mobile, then N300 router will give maximum 300 Mbps data rate speed on 2.4 GHz band, and AC1200 router will give 866.7 Mbps speed on 5 GHz band. If you have 50 Mbps ISP plan and N300 Wi-Fi router, then you will get speed 50 Mbps only, not 300 Mbps speed. Your internet speed is decided by ISP and not by Wi-Fi router that you have. Here, note the difference between small Mbps and capital Mbps. 1 Mbps in small letter means 1 megabits per second, and 1 Mbps in capital letter means 1 megabytes per second. If you divide 300 megabits per second by 8, then you will get 37.5 megabytes per second. When you transfer the files, it will show capital Mbps, megabytes per second. So remember this. Wi-Fi speed depends on many factors. One of the factors is bandwidth. On single band Wi-Fi routers, there are 11 Wi-Fi channels. Each channel is of 20 MHz bandwidth. On that single channel, maximum data rate of 72.2 Mbps is achievable. To double the data rate, we have to increase channel width. So 802.11n standard includes a technique called as channel bonding. In that technique, two 20 MHz channels combine together to form single 40 MHz channel. And that's how we can double the speed. 72.2 plus 72.2 is equal to 144 Mbps, near about 150 Mbps. 802.11 AC standard supports 40, 80, 160 MHz channel bandwidth. So in 5 GHz band, using 40 MHz bandwidth, we can achieve 200 Mbps speed. Using channel bonding, combining two 40 MHz channel on 80 MHz bandwidth, we can achieve 433.3 Mbps speed, and using 280 MHz channel on 160 MHz bandwidth, we can achieve 866.7 Mbps data rate speed. In market, there are two types of Wi-Fi router available. Some router supports 802.11 AC Wave 1, which supports 20, 40, 80 MHz channel bandwidth, while other supports 802.11 AC Wave 2, which supports 20, 40, 80, 160 MHz channel bandwidth. Prices are different for both, so note this before buying a new router. To get more speed, technique called MIMO is used. You may have seen on some Wi-Fi routers there are 2 antennas, 3 antennas, 4 and 8 antennas. These antennas are not for design or look purpose. Here MIMO technology is used. In MIMO technology, multiple antennas are used. All the speed that I have discussed till now is achieved by using single antenna. If we use multiple antennas, then we can further increase the speed. Using single antenna system, router can send only single data stream. If we use two antennas, then router will divide the data stream into two and can send two data streams on both the antennas on single channel. So we can double the data rate speed. If we use three antennas, then router will divide the data stream into three and can send three data streams on all three antennas on single channel. Let's understand this better with analogy. If you are drinking cold drink with straw, then using single straw, you require more time to empty the bottle. But if you use two straw, then time required will be half. And using three straw, less time will require. Just like that, the more number of spatial stream, lesser time will require to transmit the data. 802.11 AC supports maximum 4 spatial streams. While buying Wi-Fi router, if specification mentioned 2x2, then it means router supports 2 transmit spatial stream and 2 receive spatial stream. If 3x3, then it means 3 transmit, 3 receive. And 4x4 means 4 transmit, 4 receive. Wi-Fi router speed also depends on MCS index. MCS means modulation and coding scheme. Higher the MCS index, higher the data rate. All the routers working on 802.11n supports MCS index 7, in which modulation used is 64 QAM and coding rate is 5x6. If we use 40 nanosecond guard interval with 20 MHz channel, we will get maximum 72.2 Mbps speed. And with 40 MHz channel, we will get maximum 150 Mbps speed. And this data rate is using one spatial stream. Using two spatial stream, speed will be double, and on three spatial stream, triple. With four spatial stream, it will be quadruple. 802.11n supports maximum 4 spatial data stream. So using 4x4 antenna, maximum achievable speed is 600 Mbps. All the routers working on 802.11 AC supports MCS index 9, in which modulation used is 256 QAM and coding rate 5x6. If we use 40 nanosecond guard interval with 40 MHz channel, we will get 200 Mbps speed, and with 80 MHz channel, maximum speed will be 433.3 Mbps, and using 160 MHz channel, maximum data rate will be 866.7 Mbps. All this speed is using one spatial data stream. If number of stream increases, then data rate also increases. 802.11 AC support maximum 3 to 4 spatial streams. In 802.11 AC, using 80 MHz, maximum achievable speed is 1.3 Gbps, and using 160 MHz channel, maximum achievable speed is 2.34 Gbps. If we use higher MCS index, it means MCS 11, in which 1024 QAM modulation and 5x6 coding rate is used, then speed increases further. Some vendors also support MCS 11, but that is not included in 802.11 AC. Rather, included in 802.11 AX, also known as Wi-Fi 6. For dense modulation, we need a clear Wi-Fi channel, meaning noise margin must be lesser and strong signal strength is required. So, in 802.11 AC, which uses 5 GHz, the closer the device to the Wi-Fi router, the higher the speed. Now, one more thing is to consider is you can get the maximum speed advantage only when the router and receiving device both have the same antennas. If you have 3x3 MIMO router and receiving device has 1x1 antenna configuration, then it can receive one stream and will get speed according to one stream only. If the receiving device has 2x2 MIMO, then it can receive two streams and will get speed according to two streams. In MIMO technology, the router will send data to the first device, then second, then third device. Router can't send data to all the devices simultaneously. So the device has to wait till its turn comes. So if many devices connected to Wi-Fi router and if you are watching live TV, video or playing online games, then you will get low speed, ping will be high and packet loss will be more. So to overcome this problem, there is a one more technology called multi-user MIMO is used. In this technology, router can send data to multiple devices simultaneously. So if you have a router that supports 2x2 multi-user MIMO and receiving devices have one antenna, then the router can send data simultaneously up to two devices. If the router supports 4x4 multi-user MIMO, then router can send data to single device who also supports 4x4 antenna and can send data to two devices simultaneously which have 2x2 antenna. One thing many people don't know is that Wi-Fi is a half duplex medium, just like a hub. In half duplex medium, if devices want to communicate with each other, then they are not able to send data simultaneously. Second device can't send the data until the first device completes sending the data. Similarly, on Wi-Fi, it's not possible to send and receive data simultaneously. Means if router and device want to send the data at the same time, they can't. First, router will send the data and after it completes, then only device can start sending the data. On Ethernet cable or LAN cable, two devices can send and receive data simultaneously because there is a separate cable pair for sending and separate cable pair for receiving the data. Similarly, on 3G and 4G, there is a separate provision for uplink frequency and downlink frequency. But there is no such concept like uplink and downlink in Wi-Fi. Same channel is used for uplink and downlink. In market, 50% devices like low-end mobile phone and laptops use one antenna only because we have to save battery. So most of the manufacturer makes devices with one antenna only. 30% devices like business laptop uses two antenna and 20% devices like high-end gaming laptop supports three antennas. Manufacturer not considering more than two antennas in mobile phone. Even in iPhone 11, OnePlus mobile, there are not more than two antennas. So note this point before buying a Wi-Fi router. We will never get Wi-Fi routers advertised speed because that is tested on lab environment. But in practical, speed is different. Wi-Fi router speed depends on router settings, how far the device is, how many devices are connected to Wi-Fi router. Range and signal strength. Let's talk about Wi-Fi range. Low frequency travels longer distance while high frequency travels shorter distance. That's why 2.4 GHz band cover larger area while 5 GHz band cover smaller area. Indoor Wi-Fi routers uses 5 to 9 dBi antennas. 5 dBi antenna give theoretically 500 feet range while 9 dBi will give 1200 feet range. But practically the range is different because of thick walls nearby Wi-Fi signals which attenuates the Wi-Fi router signal. As far you go from the router, range will be less. On every 3 dBm signal loss, the speed will be half. For example, you can see the specification of N300 Wi-Fi router. On minus 70 dBm, the speed is 270 Mbps, while minus 74 dBm, speed decreases to half, about 130 Mbps. On minus 74 dBm, speed is 108 Mbps, while on minus 77 dBm, speed decreases to half, 54 Mbps. Similarly, on minus 87 dBm, speed is 11 Mbps, while on minus 90 dBm, speed decreases to almost half, 6 Mbps. As I mentioned earlier, for dense modulation requires high signal to noise ratio and high signal strength. Then only we can achieve high data rate. So to achieve this, beamforming technique is used. Normal Wi-Fi antennas are omnidirectional antennas and transmit signal in every direction. This antenna also transmits signal where no device is available. Because of this, devices which requires high signal strength receives weak signal, as unnecessary power is wasted to transmit the signal where no device is present. By using beamforming technique, Wi-Fi router uses all its antenna to make constructive signal and focus the signal where device is present. So the device will get stronger signal strength and will get less noise and can achieve higher data rate. Friends, apart from single band and dual band routers, tri-band routers also available. Tri-band router not uses new frequency, but here along with 2.4 GHz, it uses 5 GHz band two times. If one 5 GHz band exhausted because of more number of device connected to the router, then router will switch to reserve 5 GHz frequency band, and because of this, router capacity increases. Routers like AC3200 and above, AC5000, AC5300 supports tri-band. If your house is big or you live in multi-floor apartment, you will get less signal strength in one of the room or floor. So to overcome this problem, new concept mesh router is introduced. In mesh router, your main router will be connected to ISP line and other extended router known as satellite will be placed in the room or floor where you get weak signal. So you get seamless Wi-Fi coverage all over the home. So that's all about the Wi-Fi router specification. Hope this will help you to buy best Wi-Fi router. Thanks for watching. Like, share and subscribe to the channel. Have a good day.